La clase, hoy vamos a tomar apuntes del imperativo familiar. Vamos a escribir el número, la fecha y el título. Imperativo familiar. Bien. It's also known as positive two commands. Commands. Okay. And we're going to start with the regular forms. Okay. Okay. So, to form the positive command, or the positive two commands, take the to form of the present tense and drop the S. Yeah. So one thing you must know is that two commands are used to tell or command someone what to do in a polite way. All right. So, to form the positive two commands, take the to form of the present tense of a regular verb and drop the S. So let's get an example here. Tú hablas presente, ¿sí? So, we're going to drop the S, and that's our command. Habla. So, I'm commanding someone to speak. Habla. Tú conduces. Conduce. Conduce. Tú escribes. Escribe. ¿Sí? Yeah. All right. So, if the command is reflexive, if the verb is reflexive, so what do? Take off the se from the end of the infinitive. Conjugate the verb like you have done it above. What we just did up here, right here. And then add te. Because remember, these are two commands. So, tú is a pronoun, the reflexive pronoun for te is the reflexive pronoun for to, right? For example, so we have tú te levantas. So we're going to say levántate. And we're going to have an accent mark on the third syllable. The third syllable. Tú te duermes. Levántate. Duérmete. Third syllable. Tú te sientas. Siéntate. Third syllable. So what happens if the stem change? What happens to that? You still same change here. Okay? All right. So now we need to talk about the irregulars. They need to be memorized. Another way. So, which ones are irregulars? For the C, we have D. For E, we have B. For C, C. Salir, sal. Hacer, haz. Tener, ten. Irse, vete. Poner, pon. Cerrar, cierra. ¿Eh? Bien. So now, positive two commands with pronouns. Okay, so how do we form them? So it's going to be something like this. Command plus IOP or command plus DOP or both. Command How does that look like? We have the command preparas. We have the conjugated verb preparas. So we need the command prepara. And we want to add in direct object pronoun preparala. In this case, we're always going to put the accent mark in the third syllable. Compras. Compra. Celos. We add them. Accent mark in the fourth syllable. So see right here. Right here we have command plus direct object pronoun. right? And right here we have command plus indirect object pronoun plus direct object pronoun, right? Yep. What about if when this conjugation is only one syllable? That's going to be Danilo. And we always put the accent mark on the third syllable. And you see here we have command plus indirect object pronoun plus direct object pronoun. Yeah. In this case, object pronouns are always attached to the end. Always. Okay? They're always attached to the end. Yeah. So now we need to talk about one more thing. Negative two commands. To form negative two commands. What do we do? One, we need the yield form. Two, drop the O in the yield form. And three, we add the ending, right? So, AR endings are ES, IR, AR, ES. All right, so we have the regular. We have the regular ones. But we have como. We need to make that a negative two command. No. We drop, we have the yo form, como. We drop the O and we add an ending. No comas. No comas. But digo. Again. We have the yo form. We drop the O. We add an ending. No digas. See? Okay. In here. In here, you must know that object pronouns always come before the verb. Can I give you an example? No la escribas. Another one, no la escuches. No te duermas. Another one. Okay. All right. So now we talk about the irregular. Okay, and they have their own way, right? Stop. Okay. Eat that. Okay. No seas. No estés. No vayas, tú no, sepas, tú no des. Okay? All right. Verbs in, no. Verbs in negative to command. Do stem change. Something you need to remember. Okay, hey, that's about it. Haz tu práctica. And if you have questions, let me know.